Welcome, welcome everyone. Hello, welcome. Thank you very much for joining. How are you today? Hello, hello, hello. Hello, Facebook. Hello, Instagram. Hello, YouTube. Welcome, everyone. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Welcome, welcome. Спасибо. Спасибо. Yeah. Back. Back. Please. Back. Yes, yes. Спасибо. Thank you. Hello, everyone. Спасибо. Oh. I think this is my... No, 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 no. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Thank you, everyone. Thank you, thank you, thank you for joining. I left my notepad. Hello, Iffy, baby. How are you? Welcome. Thank you very much for joining. Hi, Lai. Welcome. Theophilus, how are you? Hello, Edwina. Hello, Uwa. How are you? Stella, welcome. Thank you very much. Adejuma, welcome. Thank you, Edwin. Adewale, welcome. Hi, Grace. Hello, Helen. Welcome. Annabelle, welcome. Thank you very much, everyone. Esther, Nosa, welcome. Hello, Olayemi, welcome. Hello, Mrs. Olojo, welcome, welcome, welcome. Please share, 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 guys. I appreciate you all for joining again today. So we're going to continue with Pastor Enoch Adeboye, 2019 Coded Prophecies. And then I put the General Overseer of Dishonesty, Pulpit, plagiarism, okay? If you, most people know what plagiarism is, but if you don't know, I will get the definition out for you. It just means this honest ownership of somebody else's words or somebody else's thoughts or ideas is plagiarism. So in action, 2019, so I didn't put the dates and everything there. So guys, we need to continue with this, and I hope you guys also will contribute and share your thoughts and your opinions. I actually want somebody to prove me wrong in this. What I wrote today in my comments when I put out the banner is that Adeboye and all the charlatans, because I know on Twitter I get a lot of abuse on that the governments are the ones that are messing up the country. But I will put it to you that all these criminal activities that is happening in the country, they are virtues that were learned in the church. They were not learned anywhere else. It's a religious sect and their home. That's where you learn most of what you know. In terms of education, yes, you learn at school. But even those people that were teaching you at school, their virtues and their virtues and their vices is learned from home or in their religious sects. So Adeboye now coming up with the apostles, with what the apostles have written that's been written many years ago as his own, that God told him this, and sharing with the gullibles, with the willing slaves. So I want to say beggars believe, but really it doesn't. You know, this is what he's been doing for so many years. It's just now that we caught up to it and we're talking about it. So I really want you to share your thoughts and your opinions today. It's important you do, so that also they know where they're going wrong. Because I'm also of the opinion, and this is where I give the benefit of doubt, that maybe these people are not aware of this, because we never complain. So they think that if nobody is complaining, then let's continue to do what we're doing. You know, nobody is complaining. What's the problem? And I think that's part of the issues that we have, when nobody is complaining about anything. So let's do that now. Well, not just complaining, but prefer solutions. Talk about these things and then prefer solution for those issues. So again, it's Adeboye, Pastor Enoch Adeboye, 2019 Coded Prophecies, General Overseer of Dishonesty. He is a GO of dishonesty. He is very dishonest, okay? And this is what I term this as is pulpit plagiarism. He's plagiarizing the work of the apostles, the work in the Bible, and saying that it is his own, or God told him that. You know, the definition of prophecy is something to prediction of the future. He didn't predict anything. So he's saying that he's predicting. He is giving a prophecy. So he's basically saying that he is predicting what would happen using the scriptures that have been given in the past. So what is he predicting exactly? I just want to know, what is he predicting? Anyway, I'm going to show you the video again. And then he used a story in the Bible, the story of Jesus and his disciple. He used it in this false prophecies. And then he has used it in another analogy that was given some time ago. Recently, we did it. So I'm going to show you both videos and how Adeboye used scriptures to manipulate the people. He would look for a scripture to fit his agenda. He's not the only one, by the way. Please, guys, I want you all to note that it's not just Adeboye that does this. All the religious charlatans do this, okay? So they use scriptures to fit their agenda. Here he's talking about one thing. In the video that I will show you, he's talking about another thing. And he's using the same scripture to back both up. So he tells you he's a professional, dishonest person. He's a con artist. He is a con artist. Yeah, did I say that? All right. Not C-O-R-N. Con. C-O-N. He's a con artist. And you need to know that. You know, at least be informed to make the right decision. Don't be deluded that this guy is of God and he wants your best interest at heart. That's why I don't want anybody to be. I want you to know everybody for who they are. And then let's move on with what we can do about it. You know, not to sulk over it, but to find a way to, so that we're not conned by these people for the rest of our lives. So here we go. I'm going to share these videos with you. Just bear with me. I'm actually looking for my video so that I can also see your comments. Thank you very much, everyone. Please share this with as many people as possible so that they could also contribute and share their own thoughts and their own opinions as well. I appreciate you for joining. I appreciate you for your comments and everything. I learned so much from your comments. So, guys, keep them coming so that I also can continue to learn. I appreciate everyone. So, I'm looking for the video. Let me see. Wow. All right. Hello, everyone. I appreciate you joining. Thank you. So if you're watching later, please subscribe to the channel. So it's YouTube channel, Mayowa Olaya. Please subscribe to that as well if you're watching later. And share this. That's the most important thing. You know, the reason I do this with you guys every day is so that we can all have sound mind and know what we're doing so that we're not conned anymore. Religion has been used to con us. Is this guy doing this deliberately? One second, please. Hello, Tunde. Hello. Hello. You see, the person is not even going to say anything. Okay. So that equals to a block. Yeah, that's what is going to happen to you. Block this nuisance. Block. Yeah, we won't be disturbed anymore. Sorry about that, everyone. Sorry about that. What? It's blocking one place. Sorry about this. I'm going to switch off. Hello? Hello? Right, I think there's something wrong here. One second, please, everyone. Apologies. This is just great. All right, I do apologize for that. Somebody just decided to call me randomly. The person's name is Tunde. I don't know who it is on this. And if I don't pick it up, it kept on trying. But it's blocked now, so it shouldn't interrupt anymore. Thank you very much, everyone. Sorry about that. I do apologize. Okay. One second. All right. So I'm going to play the video from of the prophecy and then show you the part where this guy is also bamboozling us with scriptures again. And today, luckily, a friend of mine provided me with scriptures. Guys, you know, I'm not a pastor at all, okay? I'm just an ordinary human being like you, but I use my sound mind. I use what God has given me. I'm not going to be waiting on another individual to tell me what to do or where to go or how to approach God or my relationship with God. I don't care for that, okay? And I don't think anybody should care for it. I make God proud by showing God that I myself, I am capable of understanding His words, right? And using His words without having to go to a deity or some sort of middleman to tell me, oh, what did God say? So what is God trying to say here? Yes, if I want to learn something I don't know, I can. But not you coming at me all the time to tell me this is what God means. Peace off. That's what I want to say to all the pastors and all the preachers. You're all actually a failure if you keep going to people and telling them they should come to you to tell you something. Because you've been teaching them all these years and none of them could be teaching themselves or teaching multitudes. Anyway, I'm just going to continue with this program today. And here we go with the video for today. Here it is. So I'm going to share this one first. Oh, maybe I should share the other one first. Let me share this. Do you remember this video, everybody? Here, I'm going to share this one first.
And you thought probably I forgot. But the new name is in the text I read to you. He said the elect of God. The elect of God. Now, what is the meaning of the elect? It means the favorite. The beloved. The one who God has chosen to love. Now, maybe I'll just give you an example. John chapter 13. You can read it from verse 21 to 26. John 13 from 21 to 26. The Lord was at dinner table with his 12 apostles. And he began to talk. And said that one of them was going to betray him. And everybody was asking, is it me? And it wasn't forthcoming. Then Peter turned to John. And said, ask him. If he doesn't tell everybody else, he will tell you. So, John, and you know his title is the beloved, drew close and said, Lord, who is the fellow? Now there were 12 of them at the table. And Jesus said to him, well, don't let me mention his name, but I will show you a sign. I will take a bit of bread, put it in the stew, and put it in the mouth of the fellow. Whoever that fellow is, that's the traitor. Don't let anybody deceive you by saying that God loves us equally.
Okay, guys, do you remember this video? So I showed this video, I think, a couple of weeks now. And now, this same story, this is another scenario. This is when he was trying to manipulate the congregation that God has favorites, okay? And that he is one of God's favorites. Then, today, in this video that we, the prophecy video in 2019, this guy used the same video or the same story, not video, the same story to explain to people that God, also, in this case, is God is giving John coded information. But it's not coded. You see how messed up Adeboye is? Adeboye is one of the most messed up individuals that I know that is on the pulpit. He is so manipulative that he is even deluded himself. It is not possible for you to delude other people if you don't end up deluding yourself. You will end up deluding yourself. Especially if you've been deluding people for a prolonged period of time. You are bound to delude yourself. This is lessons, not for just for Adeboye. It's lessons, in fact, not for Adeboye anymore. Because he's chosen his lot. These are lessons for us, for me and you. How can somebody be deluding people so much, knowing that it is recorded, knowing that there's a possibility that the same God that you think that you serve, that God can raise other people up to know better? And you continue to lie like this unless you're deluded. This guy is completely deluded. So he's going to use the same scripture and the same story to tell people this. Let's watch this one.
So your prayer then will not be saying, God, heal me. God, no.
It's not here.
Glory be to God. For the international scene.
Oh, shut up. Let me start from the beginning. I'm sorry.
In the year 2019. The devil will have no part in your money. I decree that the Almighty God will bless you abundantly. And as He provides for you abundantly, you'll be able to do His work abundantly. I decree that the Almighty God who has brought you into 2019 will support you throughout the year in Jesus' name. So shall it be. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. Let me hear you shout another hallelujah. Please be seated. As the year was running to an end, as usual, I sought the face of the Lord. Father, what is the new year going to be like? And then we have a little problem. The little problem is that in Nigeria, this is election year. And anything I say will be twisted by who? By politicians. So Lord, I want to know, what's the new year going to be like? And yet, I'm even afraid that if you tell me and I tell them, it will be twisted. Oh, thank God for God.
I mean, the lie is right from the beginning, but here he's going to use the same story again. You know, he's trying to say God told him that, he was telling God that, oh, Nigeria is election year. Like, God doesn't know that it's election year, that is Nigeria. Like, you're talking to your witchcraft doctors, your witch doctors. And then he said, thank God for God. So God suggested this. Look at what God suggested. You think God is a gossip like him, dithering. Can you imagine at 70-something, you're still a dithering? Jesus Christ.
It's a good thing to be close to God. I beg you this year, be close to Him. So the Lord reminded me, He said, that's no problem. You remember when at the table, the last supper I had with my disciples, when I said that one of them will betray me, and they were asking who will do it, and Peter beckoned to John, my beloved, and said, you ask him, he will tell you. And John asked me, and I told John, I won't mention his name, but I will take a little bit of bread, put it in this seal, and put it in his mouth. He said, we can still talk in codes.
I have to laugh. I cannot cry. God said to you, we can still talk in code. Guys, I just want to emphasize on this, okay? The same story this guy used to tell the people that God has got elect, a special, his favorites. And he's trying to say he is one of God's favorites, okay? In the same story, he used it to justify having to lie to you, plagiarize other people's words, the words that were written by apostles as his own prophecy. I mean, what idiots, what level of dingbatness is in the people that are listening to this guy? What level of mental derangement is this? The same story. Can anybody help me out? Please. How can he use the same story to justify different things? This guy actually thinks that he's God's favorite in the world because he's been able to scam as many people. Adeboye, let me tell you. When Evans the kidnapper, was successfully kidnapping people and taking the money and making himself rich, he was also thinking that he's God's favorite because he was getting away with it. When a rapist is carrying out rape and getting away with it and nobody is knowing, he or she is also believing that he is favorite of God. He knows what he's doing. When a thief is stealing and getting away with it and he's not getting caught, they always think, God is on my side. God is on my side. That's why I'm able to get away with it. Wake up, Enoch Adeboye. By you getting away with all this shit that you've been doing all over these years and nobody's saying anything, you are not God's favorite. I have seen that this guy is completely deluded. The same story, different scam. Can you imagine? He is scamming people on different levels. But his master's is in manipulating people and suggesting. His auto-suggestion is on another level. This guy has deluded these people and turned them into dummies. When you see a nation the way it is in Nigeria, please stop looking at the government that are there for 4-8 years maximum. Look at the faith leaders that have been leading masses for the last 30 years and more or more. Don't look at government, look at Adeboye for the problems of Nigeria. When somebody comes out and lie and deceive in this magnitude, and you're not even considering him as the problem of Nigeria, you have a problem. This is the problem that we have. He lied to get whatever he wants. He will manipulate. He will lie on God. He will say that God did this. God said to him, God says, I'm the first person to call God daddy. Who give a shit? Are you the first person to change the plight of your people, Nigerians? I mean, I've never seen somebody delude himself like this. Let's watch it again. So he tells this dingbat story.
That one of them will betray me. And they were asking who will do. I'm even afraid that if you tell me and I tell them, it will be twisted. Oh, thank God for God.
We have a caller, everyone.
It's a good thing to be close to God.
Shut up, hello. Adeboye. Hello, good afternoon. Who's calling, please?
Yeah. My name is Peter Wonje from Germany.
Hello, Peter. Welcome. Please share your thoughts.
Yeah, good. Mm-hmm. Okay, yeah. I don't really have much to say, but I just want to know if... are we still in the dispensation of the Old Testament, or are we still in New Testament? Because after the death of Jesus Christ, I don't think it's important to have prophet and all that, because after the death of Jesus Christ, is the apostles that they are the new men of God. Then, so but now what is happening in Nigeria is like they are still back to those days of the Old Testament. So I don't know if I'm confused. I want to know if we are still in the dispensation of the Old Testament, or when Jesus Christ said it is finished, is it really finished, or are we still back?
But Peter, Peter, you've answered your question. I'm not even a pastor. You know, Peter, you know the answer to this. You answered that question. Don't let anybody tell you that you don't know God, or you don't know the Bible, or you don't have the anointing to understand the word of God, or the or what God is trying to say. You don't have the spirit to know it. You know the answers.
Okay.
Why don't you even asking that question? When Jesus Christ said it is finished, whose word are you going to take? Jesus Christ's words or the words of Adeboye or anybody? Who are you going to take?
Yeah, you take. I'm confused.
You are not confused. You are not confused.
Maybe I'm dreaming.
You are not dreaming. Okay, you are not confused. They are the ones that are confused. You have to stand with confidence with what you know, because God is inside of you and you know the truth. So don't let anybody say because they have a bishop title, GO or whatever, they don't know more than you. You know your God yourself. And you've answered that question. Jesus Christ said it is finished. You're not concerned with anything that anybody else says after Jesus Christ. He has spoken. Okay. That is it.
Yeah, thank you very much.
Thank you. Thanks for your call.
Bye, thank you. Thank you. Bye.
Hello, guys. Seriously, I am not a pastor. I'm just a sound-minded person. And I want us all to get away from that, you know, go and ask a pastor whatever they tell you is the truth. No. Clearly, these people are saying things for their own interest, based on their own worldview. You have to trust the God that created you, that what you believe, what you know is true, by you researching it, by you checking the facts and saying, okay, is this true? Who is more powerful? Who is more... who has more authority, Jesus or the people that were in the Bible? Who should I listen to? Who should I take the words? If you are a follower, if you are a Christian, you're a follower of Christ, not a follower of denomination, not a follower of Geos, not a follower of Adeboye or Oyedepo. You are a follower of Christ, not them, okay? They are also like you. They have brains like you. You have brains. They have hands. They have mouths. They have eyes. They have ears. You have all of that. The person that created and gave them all those things gave you yours. Why is yours the counterfeit and theirs is the best that you, they can talk and they can do the things that they're doing to you? Stop wasting your time with all these dingbats. They know nothing. Even you, you can deduce yourself that they're lying. Let's go back to this, please. I want us to go back to this, what he said here.
I beg you this year, be close to him.
You know, Adeboye's manipulation is on another thing. He's trying to say that because he's so close to God, they had a conversation, and that conversation was about what he's going to share with you. So he went to God. I mean, let me just start this part again. You have to really hear this to understand what we're talking about.
In the year 2019, the devil will have no part in your money.
Okay, he's praying that in the year 2019, the devil would have no part in the money. If the money is gone from the devil in the first place, I mean, this is all rubbish. You know, all this prayer, the devil will have no part in your money, is rubbish, nuisance prayer. These are auto-suggestion. If somebody says to you that the devil will have no part in your money, that suggests to you that there's a possibility for the devil to have a part in your money. But it is not true. How would the devil have part in your money when you're under the umbrella of God, under the shelter of God? What has the devil got to do with you? When you are, God is inside of you, you are with God as well. So he said that the devil would have no part in your money. Rubbish. In fact, those kind of things negate you being in that church in the first place. You negate the fact that you're in that coven. Why would you be praying in this place where you say that you went to meet God, that the devil would have no part in your money? It's rubbish nonsense. These people are just wasting your time. You know, it's a useless dead prayer.
Decree that the Almighty God will bless you abundantly.
So you decree that the Almighty God will bless you. So what? I mean, okay, thank you for decreeing. What does your decree do for anybody? Decree that Boko Haram will stop. Decree that the henchmen will stop the killing. Decree that every good thing, Nigeria will not be in poverty anymore. And people will get common sense. I mean, what is all this during prayer and everybody's just shouting, amen. Please, guys, receive your sound mind back. Hey, look at all these people there standing there saying amen. Rubbish nonsense. Ah, Jesus Christ.
And as he provides for you abundantly, you'll be able to do his work abundantly.
You see, 419. He cares less about God providing for you. But he's saying it for the sake of, again, Adeboye is a criminal. He is good at auto-suggesting. This guy can actually propel you to go and steal. This guy can push you. He can propagate for you to go and steal, kill, destroy, and do all sorts of things. Because he will not say it. He will not say it in the word. He will just suggest different things to you, which will lead you to criminal activities. I mean, what does this mean? As God provides for you, you will do his work. Whatever. Just shut up, Adeboye. You're just talking trash. As usual.
I decree that the Almighty God who has brought you into 2019 will support you throughout the year in Jesus' name.
What does that even mean? The Lord that brought you to 2019 will support you throughout the year.
So shall it be. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. Let me hear you shout another hallelujah. Please be seated. As the year was running to an end, as usual, I sought the face of the Lord.
We have a caller. Hello, caller. Hello.
Yeah, can you hear me? This is Ebere.
Hello, Ebere. Yes, we can hear you. Go ahead.
Okay. I don't know what people are sitting down listening to Adeboye. He doesn't even trust himself.
Hmm.
I don't know what... He has nothing to say. He's even afraid.
Mm-hmm.
And for me, if you are afraid, that means you don't have a sound mind, don't have the spirit of God in you. Because if you have the Spirit of God in you to cast out all fear, it's in the Bible. And I don't know why people always look out for prophecy. I don't know if you guys saw the video of the guy in Biafra that they prophesied that his children, three children, were witches.
Yeah.
And he took them to the bush and gave them this, this thing they used to kill spider, forgotten the name now.
Oh,
and
my
those
God.
Forced them to drink it.
Oh, my
two
God.
Died and one escaped.
Wow.
If on to their fake prophecies. And I don't know why these people up to now refuse to know that they are doing more harm than good.
Yes.
To people. God taught us, Christ taught us how to pray. It's simple. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, not Adeboye's kingdom come. That will be done on earth as it is in heaven. That is bringing that peace of heaven here. Give us this day our daily bread, not to acquire and acquire and acquire for great, 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 great grandchildren. Nigeria is a place where 21 years after Abacha's departure, they are still discovering his roots, for goodness sake. Do we really think when we do some things we do? His generation has been cursed because you acquire so much for them. So they will not use the God-given gift that he gives to everybody because they have more than enough. Why will I go and walk? I mean, it's simple. You are shortchanging the world. You are not using the gift God has given to you. For everybody, God gives a gift. They will sit down and listen to somebody because I can't stand that the way. I'm sorry.
Yeah, don't be
he
sorry. He can't stand himself too. He can't stand himself. I don't think this guy looks in the mirror. He looks at himself. The lies is too much.
I mean, he's not even talking with confidence. He doesn't even know what to say. But he just got to say something. And people will just listen. And they will accept to it. How can you shut your mind while you're living? This thing is simple. I remember in our days, when the word of God, when we didn't have all these Pentecostals that came and brought division and brought fear. I will use my mind. I was talking to my elder sister that I've been jumping from one church to another. I don't take it like that. As I told her, they told you some time ago that I was what is it called? That was the Marine or whatever they told
me. Oh my God.
But now,
I think every woman
of yours, that Marine sister of yours is the one that has your back.
Oh my God.
That has never left you. And you're collecting. Get a life. People should just get a life and know that people have nothing to say. If you watch the video of that man yesterday, I watched it yesterday, that killed his children.
I didn't see the video.
Because somebody said,
wow.
And it's all these fake prophecies that they are witches, innocent children. You will stand in that pit when you know deep down in yourself that you have had nothing from God. You can't even hear nothing from God because you are even afraid.
Yes, he's afraid.
You don't even have the Spirit of God in you. And now you're dragging people along and people are following. You can't stop going to these places. When we really have few churches. That was love. I remember in my compound, your mom don't need to be around for you to eat. You can go to auntie's house and eat food. Trust. That was relationship.
Yeah, but they've ruined that now.
Love.
They've ruined that. They always tell you, be careful. Be careful of this.
Maiwa, these preachers have taken the best thing and give us rubbish.
Yeah.
Which is love and relationship. And now they have made Nigeria one lane, thinking just one side. Prosperity, and we're not even getting we're getting poorer.
Yeah.
Desperate people make mistakes. Average Nigeria is desperate, and that's why we're making mistakes everywhere. I don't know why people cannot get it. The most important thing is how you make people feel. If I come to your house and you give me money, give me something, we'll give you some time, I will spend that money. That club, I will maybe probably not like it anymore. I'll go it or something. But how you make me feel will remain with me. That's one thing I will remember you for. Even for so many years, if I don't see you, that is called love. They've taken it away with their nonsense preaching that they are preaching, dividing family up and down.
Yeah.
For those that believe, because you can tell me rubbish. If, even if somebody... Hello?
Hello. Thank you very much, Ebere. Thank you. I appreciate your call.
I hope I've been able to contribute something.
Yes, you did. You did very well. Thank you. I appreciate it.
All right. Thank you so much. Okay. I appreciate what you do.
Thank you.
God bless you.
Amen. Thank you. Honestly, guys, it's really sad. When you think about the damage that these people have done, then it's just, it's too much to bear. You know, as Barry was talking, I was just thinking the families that they don't even talk anymore. They've told them that their mother is a witch, their grandmother is a witch, your sister is from marine spirit, your sister is a witch. Look at the guy that Barry was talking about. They told him that his children are witches or witch or they have something. And he took them to the bush to kill them and gave them snipers. Somebody wrote here. And, you know, only one of them escaped. Two died. You know, the children that he's brought. Oh. Honestly, religion is killing us. And these people like Adeboye, they are, you know, whenever the father does something, Dr. Sunday always uses this as an example. The children will do worse. And this is why we have to nip this in the bud now. If we don't do anything, you see, when you see people like TB Joshua, you think that TB Joshua is bad. He learned from these people. He learned from Adeboye. If Adeboye is tiny bad, TB Joshua will be like 1 yard of bad. That is what is happening.
Father, what is the new year going to be like? And then we have a little problem. The little problem is that in Nigeria, this is election year.
Okay, so you went to tell God that because he can't see, he doesn't know, he's not omni, what's this word, where God can see everything that's happening. He knows even before you knew that it was going to be election year. God knew which year. God knows everything, right? So you went to say, oh God, the only problem that we have is that this is election year. Really, Adeboye? I mean, do you not even think about what you're saying? Don't you even play it back to yourself? Or maybe you should sit your family down, sit Leke and everybody down and say, okay, this is what I'm going to say. Does it make sense? Is it good con? Is this a good con? Omnipresence, thank you. Adelaye, thank you. Omnipresence, you have to go and tell the omnipresence God that he is going to be election. Yeah, we are in election year in 2019. I mean, who's this guy kidding? I don't understand. Who are the dingbats? God, please, let them use their brain. How long are we going to do this for? How can these people not even figure this out? Jesus Christ. Plutonic is asking why the police never arrest these guys. Because the police also is taken out of this scam. Thank you, Ogunsaki. God is omnipresence and omniscience. Why would you be saying, oh, it's election year to that God that knows before you knew? And it's like he is the one that is manipulating God. So you have to give information to God for God to give you ideas. Come on. I mean, this is just madness. And I mean, people saw this and said that it's coded. This coded is not even the whole thing. I was just seeing the whole picture of how this man went to God and said, yes, I'm sorting you for the year 2019. What's going to happen? Why are you even anxious for 2019? I thought you were a believer. He says in the Bible, do not be anxious for anything. Why, Adeboye, do you want to go and sort God? Let God say, I want to reveal myself to you. So you went to, it's God Babalawo, because you're used to all those things. That's all Adeboye knows. Adeboye is just wearing suit and bow tie because he doesn't like the fashion of the herbalist and all this Babalawo in Africa. He preferred this type of fashion and he thought this is better to stand up instead of sit down on the floor. You know, altogether, this guy is an herbalist himself. And Enoch Saboteur. Somebody just wrote, yeah, Fortune. Huh? Hello, Chuka. Welcome. Can you believe this nonsense?
And anything I say could be twisted by who?
this guy, man. Have you ever seen somebody that manipulates like this? He's even getting the audience, the congregation to add. Everything I said might can be twisted by whom? So they would be the one to say, oh, but you guys were the one that says politician. I'm sure they didn't even say politicians. Politicians don't even say anything about you. You are the one that starts saying all sorts of things about politicians. You are no Yedepo. It's not a politician that this guy wants to say. He wants to say by the media. He said politician. Didiring. It's not Didiring. He thinks he's trying not to be Didiring, but you are Didiring. Mm-hmm. You are Didiring. Because anything I say will be too say, what concern you? What concern them with you? You are the one that is going to kiss their asses, being their lap dog everywhere. Buhari there. If it's not Buhari, you go to the other one. Mm-hmm. When the politician come to you, you pastors are the ones that your dingbat thieves, arm robbers, that go from the pulpit to go and beg money from the politicians. Yes. We know that you go to beg money. You go to lick their asses to get money and predict to them. The politician come to you. Hmm? Only 419. Pulpit bandits. Kala, na lie, na lie, na lie.
My politicians. So Lord, I want
to... Which politician? Adeboye, tell me, which politician is going to twist your words? Every time you guys give predictions, you say that this is going to happen, your prophecy doesn't happen. And they do not have the right to say that you said this and it didn't happen. So why are you afraid to tell the truth? Why, by the way, are you even worried? When God sends you something, you have nobody to fear. You fear the person that sent you, the Almighty God. Why are you fearing politician? Why the respect and honor for politician more than for God? Now you're saying that God helped you to twist and cook up a scam. Come in. Look at that.
No, what's the new year going to be like? And yet.
So, I think this guy is meant to say that I went to Ifa and I went to ask Ifa what the new year is going to be like. Because it's not God that you went to ask what the new year is going to be like. God is not your mate, okay? Stop talking trash. It pisses me off whenever he's talking like this. Thank you, Femi. He is making mockery of what Christianity is about. I went to God and I said, what is 2019 going to be like? Really? Really, Adeboye? And then he gave you the scriptures that has been written by apostles in the past.
I'm even afraid that if you tell me...
Because it's a liar that is afraid. He says that if you do well, you will not be afraid. Your heart will be clear. It's because you didn't do well. It's because you're a liar. It's because you're a thief. None of us are afraid. God is not the author of our confusion. Who's afraid there? Is anybody afraid of anything? You know? Yes, he goes to meet oracles. It's Edwina, you're right. It's like he's going to meet an oracle. He's afraid. Adeboye, you're afraid because you're a liar. You're afraid because you've been lying for so many years and you realize that you're being caught. If you do something that is good, you're not going to be afraid. Your heart will be free. You will know that your Almighty God is the one that said this thing. So what have I got to be afraid for? It's too fake, Lady Cynthia. Completely fake. So what are you afraid of? Tell us, what are you afraid of? You're afraid that people will know the truth. Oh, I see. Yeah. That you can't deceive them anymore. You're afraid that you're not relevant anymore. You've never been relevant, but you had hold on to it for so long. So now you're irrelevant. People don't need you anymore. So you're just going to be cooking up any kind of stew so that you can remain relevant. Just go and sit there. You know, somebody was telling me, guys, the other day, it was yesterday, that if Adeboye had resigned, JJ, when they called for him to resign a few years ago, that he would not be facing ridicules like this. What do you guys think about that? And then the person told me the story about, I think it's Ezekiah, that asked God to increase his years, and God gave him 15 more years. You know, I know of that story, But in my previous church, my previous pastor used to tell us as though God did him, you know, it was a great thing that he had 15 extra years. Apparently, the 15 extra years that Ezekiah had was 15 miserable years that it really messed him up. I didn't even know that. I haven't read it yet. So if anybody can concur on that, please let us know. So if this guy has gone jeje when they told him, resign, Adeboye, you see, lesson of your life. If you had resigned a few years ago, we could be ridiculing other people. We wouldn't even mention your own name. Because you wouldn't be in the spotlight. You wouldn't be anywhere. You'd just be enjoying the stolen money that you stole. But because people's head is not going to let you agree, it will not let you rest in peace. Now you stay there, and now everybody knows you for the liar that you are. Look at your life. Yeah, I'm not there. I'm telling you, it's just a conversation that somebody had with me. I'm just sharing it. Okay? I'm just sharing it. You see your life, Adeboye, ridiculous is an understatement. Eh? Now you come and just tell any lie, You see, everybody is saying correct. Dofra said correct. Moraya said correct. Ebere said exactly. The truth will free his coven slaves. Amen, Kala. Edwin says that the spirit of God has departed from them. That is why they keep exposing themselves by themselves. How can a man who call himself a pastor be afraid of what people will say? Can you imagine, Edwin? That means he is not truthful to himself. Supposed to say his word will be twisted by Mayowa and not politician. Thank you. Mayowa is not even going to twist it because he knows that I don't twist my words. I just present the video and I say it. It's not twisted. I just say that, isn't this what, did I twist anything? I present the video to you. We do the analysis together. He will say my name. Say my name, Adeboye. Then we will just yama yama each other. Please, say my name. Let's just yama yama each other. Let everybody just know. Stop lying on politicians. They never come to you. Mayowa and not politician because no politician have his time. Thanks so much. Edwin. But I don't twist his words. I say it as it is. You want me to twist it? I'm not going to twist anything. Mayowa, power greed wouldn't let him. Yes, that is true. So you see your life now. So is the story of Ezekiah like that? So now, you ask God, you beg, you hold on to the wire, and now the wire has now blown you up. It's transformed you into the known liar of the world. What would you be remembered for, Adeboye? Eh? You'll be remembered for lying. Now, they've called you, you have different names. Coded pastor. We have you as Saboteur pastor. We have you of the different thing. Mad. Three levels of mad. Only Adeboye knows the three levels of mad. Maybe he's already gone through all the madness stages. Three stages of madness. I mean, can you imagine? All the years that you've lived now, all the work that you so-called have done, look at your life. If you had resigned, Jeje, Leke, tell your dad, this shame would not be coming to him like this. Disgrace. Now you open your mouth to say that you are afraid of people. You don't even respect God. You think that God is your born boy? You are afraid of people. You are Adeboye. And you're not even afraid of God. And you open your mouth to say it on the pulpit. Look at your life. Nobody talk to you. You don't talk to yourself. If people don't talk to you, you sit down, you look in the mirror, and you start talking to yourself.
It will be twisted. Oh, thank God.
Esther said, Esther Kuganja wrote, Kuganja Adedoyin says, let him tell us what God is saying about the Elijah challenge this year. Adeboye, go ahead. Tell us about the Elijah challenge. Big time liar.
Oh, thank God for God.
Look, he wants to lie. Oh, thank God for God. I mean, Jesus. How can this guy be such a liar, a professional manipulator? Thank God for God. And then he looked elsewhere. This is a body language, everything. Guys, watch his body language. This guy knows he's lying. Oh, thank you. He couldn't look straight in the camera. He has to look away. Because when you're lying, you can't face, you can't. God has wired us in a certain way that we cannot do certain things straight, in a straight way. Oh, thank God for God. He knows how to use pauses to delay people thinking. Oh, thank God for God. Didering. Thank God for God what? Complete didering. Dingbat.
It's a good thing to be close to God.
This is another method of manipulation. He's saying it's a good thing to be close to God because you. But what he's trying to say is that because I am close to God, me and God has this. We had this conversation. You know, you guys are not close to God, so you don't know. He doesn't talk to you. He doesn't tell you what to do. He's exonerating himself. He's aggrandizing himself, and he's saying that whatever he's going to tell you now is because he's close to God. That's why he's able to say it. And if not, God will not tell him these things like this. And this is why he's got to do this and get away with it. And none of you should say anything. To say anything, you should just keep your mouth shut.
I beg you this year, be close to him.
He doesn't care if you're close to God or not. You know, he doesn't care. Felix, this is not about perfection. Please, let me do my job, okay? Let me do what I'm doing, all right? This is not about perfection. If you want to be a willing slave, continue to be a willing slave. These are for people that don't want to be slaves, that are not slaves, that have sound mind. It's not for mumus, okay? This page, this channel is not for mumu. And it's not for people that don't love truth. If you like truth, stay. If you don't like truth, please get out.
So the Lord reminded me, he said, that's no problem. You remember when at the table, the last supper I had with my disciples?
Oh, shut up. I mean, whenever he tells this story, if we read this story, it's in John somewhere, right? I read it last time. This man is telling the story and embellishing some information as well as adding information to it. He's not even telling the story correctly. He's adding pictures of what didn't even exist in that story. Esther said that you should teach your followers to learn how to be close to God. You're telling them to learn how to be close to God. You teach them how to be close to God. All these years, you're still opening your mouth in 2018/19 that they should be close to God. Why are they following you all these years and they don't know how to be close to God? Me, I only for 1 month, I watch somebody, I know how to speak, how to talk, okay? I know to be bold in Christ. 1 month. In less than 1 year, I can talk and hold conversation and be bold in Christ. They've been following you all this year, 30-something years. They still can are not close to God. Disgrace on yourself. You just put yourself into failure mode. You just said that I failed. Thank you, Esther. You see sound mind, how is operating. Learn how to be close to God. You think that you're telling people the correct thing. They don't know that you're actually showing your failure. How long have they been following you that they're not close to God? Because you're standing in the way. Ding back deity. Nobody give a shit about you. Get out of the way. And stop selling us so-coded nonsense. We're not interested in your coded prophecy. Go and give it to your generation, your ancestors. His generation would actually be my parents. Go and give it to your ancestors. Who is this Didiri now? Olubemi. Olubemi, are you okay? Are you okay, Olubemi? Didiri, willing slave. Please, I keep saying, if you want to be a willing slave, you are free. Unto freedom you're called. He didn't say that unto freedom, or unto freedom, unto the God side alone. He said unto freedom you are called. You are free to be a slave, and you're free to have sound mind and love God and be bold. If you want to be a slave, and this is your daddy and your Lord and personal savior, that is okay. If you want to be free and love God and be in love with God, then you can also be free like that. Don't come to my page and start saying that I want cheap popularity.
When I said that one of them will betray me, and they were asking who will do it, who will do it.
Twister. I mean, everybody, let's look at that scripture that he's saying. If anybody knows that scripture, it's just lying. Who will do it? Jesus.
And Peter beckoned to John, my beloved. And say,
you see, Peter beckoned to John, my beloved. He's always trying to, he's always trying to highlight that. And so what? You know, Jesus also said, David is a friend. Is a man after my own heart. And so, we're all man after. If you seek God's heart, you will be God's friend. Shut the f up.
Ask him, he will tell you. And John asked me. And I told John, I won't mention his name, but I will take a little bit of bread, put it in this seal, and put it in his mouth. He said, we can still talk in codes.
When did Jesus say that we still talk in codes? So you went to God, and God then said what Jesus did and gave that example. Your lie, it doesn't have any rival. This man's lie, Adeboye's lie, has no rival. Nobody can surpass this man's lie on earth anymore. The same damn story. Look at him here telling the story here. You see, another suit, another bow tie. That's what he wants to do. He doesn't want to wear the wrapper of those witch doctors and those babalawo. He would rather wear suit and bow tie or shirt. But it's the same thing. He's practicing the same thing that they're practicing. There's no difference. This guy don't know God. He just knows some stories in the Bible, and he will repeat those stories for anything that he wants to use it for. So here we go. The same old dingbat story. Look.
The one who God has chosen to love.
Mm-hmm.
Now, maybe I just give you an example. John chapter 13. You can read it from verse 21 to 26. John 13 from 21 to 26.
Okay. At least he gave us that chapter now. John 13. 13 from 21 to 26. Yeah. Okay. Let's look at that John 13, okay? Excuse me, everybody. I'm going to go into Bible Hub now, so you will be seeing my face. A second. John 13, 21 to 26. Okay? Okay, so I'll start from 13. I'll show you now. John 13, okay? Excuse me. Okay, so I just Googled and I just added John 13. 1 second. Okay, so any version, let's choose an English Standard Version. So after saying these things, Jesus said, troubled in his spirit. Jesus was troubled in his spirit and testified, truly, truly, I say to you, one of you will betray me. Okay, so that's where it started. So I'm going to read the English Standard Version just to make it easier, okay? 22, English Standard Version again. The disciples looked at one another, uncertain of whom he spoke. Okay? Okay. And then, English Standard, one of his disciples, whom Jesus loved, was reclining at the table at Jesus' side. So, recline, maybe went like this or like this, you know, at a table, right? One of the disciples whom Jesus loved. It doesn't mean that Jesus doesn't love the rest. But this guy is always emphasizing that Jesus loved John, and he doesn't love the rest as much. Mm-hmm. And then, so we're reading to 26. 24 says, so Simon Peter motioned to him to ask Jesus of whom he was speaking. Standard. This is normal. You know, if you live in a house with a big family, they would, some of the younger, the older people would always say, Mayawa, ask daddy this. Mayawa, ask mommy this. It doesn't necessarily mean, if you look at my mom and dad's heart, that they love me more than them. They love all their children. But, you know, I might just be the child that is not shy to ask those questions. So anyway, let's just go. Trying to aggrandize himself over nothing. So that disciple leaned back against Jesus, said to him, Lord, who is it? Okay, that's 25. And 26 says, Jesus answers, it is he to whom I will give this morsel of bread when I have dipped it. So when he had dipped the morsel, he gave it to Judas, the son of Simon. The son of Simon Iscariot. Simple. What is the drama that this guy is trying to make out of this? So that's the story. So he's using this story now that Jesus didn't lie. Jesus didn't give any code here. Jesus said exactly what he's going to do, and he did exactly what he's going to do. Even at Deboye, you just entrap yourself. This is an entrapment for you. Because now you said that Jesus is not a code. That isn't a code. Jesus said exactly what he was going to do, and he did exactly what he said he would do. It wasn't any code, but you are trying to say that it's a code. You are trying to say that he gave you prophecy, and the prophecy was a code. But it's not a code. Jesus said, I am going to dip bread. How is that a code? In this, and give it to the person that is going to betray me. What is that? What is the code there? You are giving scriptures, and you're saying that this story matches what Jesus did in John. You know, common sense is elude this guy. He's lost it. You see, you should have resigned that time. This disgrace will never come. Then we will never even talk about you anymore. We will just say, oh, that Baba was gentle and forced humility, and he left. Now you stayed. 2019, everybody is calling you coded pastor. Pastor Saboteur, Pastor Three Madmen, three kinds of madmen. That's all they'll remember you for. You see? Look at your life. Tidiring. Let's continue, guys. Liar, liar, pants on fire.
The Lord was at dinner table with his 12 apostles, and he began to talk. I said that one of them was going to betray him. And everybody was asking, is it me, is it me? And it wasn't forthcoming.
Look at that. And everybody was asking, is it me, is it me? And it wasn't forthcoming. Hey, Chai! This guy. Lie, they lie, yo. Listen, Adeboye is the lie that they lie. Hello, caller.
Hello.
Hello, Uday. Hello.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Uday.
This is about the line.
Hi, Day.
I'm fine. Happy New Year. You are doing a great job.
Thank you, sir. Happy New Year to you too.
These people, they don't have much to say. If you watch their end of the year prophecy for 2019, you find out that they have lost the battle. Just that they don't want to give up easily. You see, Nigerian Christians, the reason why we have a problem, the Nigerian Christian have a problem that we don't take stock to know how far we've done in the previous year, know our limitation, know how to improve upon things that we did get wrong. Right. That's what corporate bodies, even individual, does in every year. But you see, Nigerian Christians, at 8 years of Adeboye existence, it has always been, this year will be this, this year will be this. They shout hallelujah, drop their last money, go back home, empty stomach, not looking up to it. And the following year, same thing continue. But you see,
and then they'll come back and repeat the same thing. Insane individuals.
They'll come back and repeat the same thing. And when there's someone the courage to tell the man of God that this thing didn't work out after giving their money, do you know the response they got? Your faith is so low.
Yeah.
Your faith.
Yes.
They now put the blame back to the same people.
Yes, they take the cash to sell those things to them and put the blame on them when it doesn't happen.
And put the blame on them that it was their fault.
Mm-hmm.
And when they work for others now, they give God the glory.
Mm.
So these people, they are criminals. I watch Suleiman, over 50 provinces.
That one is this completely crazy. I mean, because Suleiman administration is sectioned, really.
Over 50 provinces. Are you now talking about Ghana receiving aid from this state? As if, is there any part of African country that never received aid from an international organization? What's that word? How does that become how does that turn to become a prophecy? And people wasted their night all throughout the night listening to this trash. It's the name of prophecy.
Oh my God.
And except tomorrow, this person will now run to Western World telling them that he's coming with the prosperity and all that to the Western World. And the same people are giving donor to African countries that he needs.
Oh my God.
Honestly, this sounds funny. These people, and the good thing because nobody knows over the years, nobody knows that somebody can call Adeboye names and tell them exactly who they are.
Because
before, if you call Adeboye a criminal, if you tell them exactly who they are, then you are mad, you are already a dead person.
How?
You are dead.
How? We are all dead. We are all going to die.
No, that is what Adeboye told them. How? That's what my anointed.
No, but we are all anointed. So when I touch you, are you telling me we are all anointed?
Through this reformer, what is going on now? Nobody knows that you can say this to whatever you want to tell them. Tell them exactly who they are. Nothing will happen. And nothing will happen because God is not their father. You need a special to give somebody. That's not the way God works. That same message that has been for the past 38 years, more than 40, since 1982, this book came into operation. That's what when Nigeria started going down.
So they've been around
since 1982. After that, you know, in 1982, he had about 380 naira in his account.
Oh, yeah, that's his account. 1984,
today, he's dangerously rich.
Yeah.
1982,
yeah.
This would have been in operation.
Oh, moly. Your time is up, mate.
And what they left behind, because they are going, what they left behind is just values, morals, everything going down.
Yeah.
Nothing again. That's what they leave behind. But thank God, Adebo is on the verge of going out. He's on the bachelor lounge. But Fanto Ibos, Chris, Oyakilomis, what's the Suleiman?
Don't worry, we'll be with them. Don't worry.
You'll fight them. Leke is a kid. He can't inherit that business because that business will not flourish. People will fight them. People that invested a lot of money to this empire will go after them and say, give me back my money.
Yeah.
And they have a business now. Will I go to court and prosecute them and get their money back?
Yes.
It will happen. It will happen.
It will.
Just what they are prophesying now, compare what they have been telling people previous years now. They are not even the last words to express what they want to say. They don't have nothing to say. How can you say, God, take what is in the Bible and now give it as prophecy? It's already in the Bible. It's already in the Bible. We can read it and know what is what Bible talking about that now. How can you tell us it's called that night?
He's a con artist. This guy is a con artist. He's like those people in England.
Criminals. These people are criminals. He's talking about politicians. This is a person who has been protecting politicians against common people. No. Their business is about to close.
Yes.
They are going.
Yeah.
When I said when Jesus is saying he's going to spend 10 years and Nigeria will be, I said 10 years is far.
Yes, 5 years.
10 years is far. Look at these young people that just met DSA. Couple of months in Nigeria, where they are about to talk.
Yes.
And look at the part they are making.
Yes, that's true.
I heard this guy that was speaking from Abuja, that what is program? That guy was speaking after. I said, he never said that people were sparking along the street. In Abuja, beggars, people that were living in a non-complicated building. But the moment he stopped going to this church now, that was why he invested his money. In the life of these people. And people that know him before, they are calling him pastor now, that he's no longer a church member, but they are calling him pastor.
because of impact he's making in his area.
Hmm.
Just think about what will happen when DSA will just spend 3 years in Nigeria.
Hmm.
People will realize that people have been in the business of pleasing people, making money, building their estate in Dubai and in just cities across the globe,
hmm.
and tell you that go and pray to God. God will do this.
Hmm.
It's unfortunate, but yeah. we are winning them.
Yes.
Thank you. Keep the good word.
Thank you very much, Ule. Look at your life, Adebuyina. People are telling you the story of your life like that. You see? You see your life? Such a shame.
Then Peter turned to John and said, ask him. If he doesn't tell everybody else, he will tell you.
Look at this dim bad guy, this bald-headed guy. He's chewing up everything that Adeboye is saying. He's even repeating it before Adeboye says it. These are the dead brains. The dead, dry up brain. Please resurrect your brain, gentlemen. With your suit and your tie and everything, resurrect your sound mind. If he doesn't tell you, he will tell you. Where did he say that in the Bible? He never said, Simon never said to him, to her, Simon Peter, therefore beckoned to him that he should ask who it should be, who you should be, of whom he speak. He didn't say, if he doesn't tell anybody, he will tell you. At the end of the day, God didn't just, Jesus didn't just tell John, he told them all there. He didn't take John on the side and said, okay, this is it. I mean, what manner of liars are in this organization? What manners of liars are in this coven? Completely morally bankrupt, Mickey. And this guy in the suit, can you see him? Can you see his face? He's chewing everything up like dithering. Look at his eyes even. It's rolled into his brain. It's like he's not even thinking anymore. He's just replaying tape. If he doesn't tell anybody, he will tell you. And his mom, he will tell you. Where did he say that in the Bible? Why are you adding to what the Bible says and what the Bible didn't say?
So, John, and you know he's trying to do his deep beloved.
Why is it he's so manipulative? He said, John, and you know his title is deadly. Shut up, Adeboye. Keep your mouth shut. Okay? Keep quiet. Zip it. Stop lying. I mean, Jesus. Guys, how do you deal with somebody that lies like this, that calls himself a faith leader in Nigeria? And you're telling me that Nigeria will be full of people that are honest. If this guy is just pastoring or is leading 1,000 people alone, that country will be in trouble. Because that 1,000 people would be around different people all over. But he is leading a bunch of dideries in their millions. What do you expect from Nigeria? We need to wake them up. They are in a slumber. This guy is going to lead them to hell. First, he's trying to take tithe for the price of heaven. It's like if you pay your tithe regularly, that's when he's going to take you to heaven. Who the hell are you to even take anybody to heaven? You yourself, are you even going to go to heaven? Yeah.
Close and said, Lord, who is the fellow? Now there were 12 of them at the table. And Jesus said to him, well, don't let me mention his name, but I will show you a sign.
Ha! This liar. Jesus said, don't let me mention his name, but I will show you a sign. Ah. Jesus answered, It is to whom I shall give a sign. I mean, Jesus didn't even say anything about, don't let me mention his name, I will show you a sign. He said, Jesus answered, he's there. They are the one, this is their own even scripture, that this is their own version. Jesus answered, he it is to whom I shall give a sop which I have dipped it. And when he had dipped the sop, he gave it to Judas Iscariot, the son of Simon. Simple. This guy just keep adding all sorts of things into this story. So he used this story to say that there's God's elect, the people that are special to God, that God told certain things, and he's a favorite of God. He used it to manipulate them on the one hand. Then he went and he used the same story here. Look, The same story.
Little bread? Who did it this you? And they were asking who will do it, who would.
Another day, this is another day, he told the same story. Look at him, another day with his prophecy, Adeboye prophecy for 2019. In 2018, he used that scripture to say that God is our favorite, and he is God's favorite, and he is God's elect. Yes. And then, here now, he wants to lie to you. He wants to plagiarize somebody else's words and use it as his. And then he says that it is God's code to him. And God gave him, because he's again a favorite. It's like John, your dearly beloved. And now God gave him this information by stealing scriptures in the Bible. I mean, I'm saying that those are prophecy. Prophecy are prediction. This has been in the Bible since over 2,000 years ago. It's been in the Bible. This guy is using it. The same thing that has been in the Bible has been used already. It's already been predicted. He's now using it as his own prediction from 2019. Could you see how this guy is such a liar? The level of your lying, I just don't understand. Even now, if I hear anybody goes to RCCG, the first thing I'm taking is alarm bell. The only thing that comes out of my head is like, okay, alarm bell, this person is likely a liar. This person likely deceives, because you are like your father. If you go to RCCG, if anybody tells me they are RCCG members, the first thing I'm thinking is liar, thief, deception. That's what I'm thinking. Just like Winners. If anybody tells me that I'm from Winners, the first thing I'm thinking, bully, evil, hatred, hungry, dingbats. That's what I'm thinking. You know, you guys, you can share your own as well. If anybody says that they're going to Mountain of Fire, first, I'm going to know that, don't even get close to me. The amount is not going to be correct. Their thinking, warped. Their behavior, warped. Everything about them, messed up. Messed up. So I don't even waste my time with people like that. Like, Tilly said it's a code. Like Deboye.
This year, be close to him. So the Lord reminded me, he said, that's no problem. You remember when?
Somebody, sorry, I want to read this. Yeah, Yemi wrote that those of us born in the 60s and 70s had good Christian foundation, but this was eroded by the culture of not being able to correct an elder who is glaringly lying. Thank you very much, Yemi, for saying this, and I appreciate you, because things like this just vindicate the reason why I say these things. Because if people like you, Yemi, it's not an insult, or I've not been afraid, you guys have known your God. Because you know what it tells me? The Bible tells me that if the foundation be good, it will be wrong, what can the righteous do? You said that you had good foundation. If that foundation was really that good, you guys would have been able to boldly speak to these dingbats. But you made a very valid point there, and it's that they kept on telling you to keep quiet, and then you kept quiet, and this is how they've grown to be liars. And this is why I deal with this. I don't want my children, I don't want your children to have to serve these slave masters. Enough is enough. They are wicked. They will do whatever they need to do with them, and they will throw your children away, and it will be another cycle. They will lie to your children. They will use them in their plantation. They will build their own empires. So I really appreciate Yemi Akin Bami for writing what she's written. This is exactly what happened. Those of us born in the 60s and 70s had good Christian foundation. They killed those people. If you know people that were born in the 60s and 70s, they know the right thing, but their mouth is shut like this. They zip them. They cow them. They deliberately oppress them. And it's enough now. All of you come out. Okay? Jesus said it is finished. It is finished. For real. All of you come out now. Especially those that were born in that time. Come out and tell the truth. Nothing would happen to you. Nobody can do nothing to you. All of us will die, including them. We will all die. We are all going 6 foot under. Some of us will not even be going 6 foot under. You will just die, and you die like that. So what? You came and you die. What is this nonsense? Please don't allow anybody to do that to you. What Yemi says here, it grieves my heart, but it's the truth. It's the absolute truth. They keep telling you, don't say anything, oh, they're men of God, oh, they're this, oh, they add culture, syncretism, all sorts of things they had to Christianity. Look how this one is lying now.
At the table, the last supper I had with my disciples, when I said that one of them will betray me, and they were asking who will do it, who will do it, and Peter beckoned to John, my beloved, and said, you ask him, he will tell you.
So this guy is saying that when he went to God for 2019 prophecy, and then he told God that I'm even afraid, this is election year. Can you imagine that shit conversation? He never had that conversation. It's just a lie. Complete lies. And then God said, okay, I know what I'm going to do for you. I'm going to help you to lie. I'm going to give you codes. Yeah? And he told the same story he told last year, less than 2 weeks ago. He told that story for another thing now. I mean, the guy is not even good. You're not even good. Hello, caller.
Hello?
Hello, caller. Hello. How are you? Hi, Don.
Hello, Mayua. Happy New Year.
Happy New Year to you.
Yeah, thank you very much. This year, when I put first. But Mayua, you just realized that this year, most of this person, they did not do their usual rituals, the prophecy that the man, they are scared. They didn't do it because
but they
didn't
do it. They are doing prophecy. They are, but
it's logic. It's not like, you know, that kind of what they used to do. I just read I read on BBC yesterday that one Ghanaian pastor did a prophecy that he said a Muslim cleric imam is going to die.
Yes.
You know what happened? The youth and the young Muslim guys, they attacked the church for a wrong, as a demonic prophecy. Why would he just be prophesying that person is going to die? Do you understand me? That the guy is going to die this year. And again, also, there was a case in Port Harcourt, right? This pastor prophesied and told the man that the reason why he's not being rich, his kids are rich.
Yeah.
This guy gave the kids sniper, three of them.
Oh.
Put them in the bush. One escaped and did not die. Been arrested. I saw the video yesterday and I said to myself, he's not telling me to wake up.
Yeah.
And the pastor in question should be arrested and put in jail.
Yes.
So the next time, they should have been here because you can't just arrest the man alone because the pastor is an accomplice.
Yes.
Do you understand me?
Yes.
Because he's so mad. Like, when I say that, people get mad at me. On my Facebook page,
why are they mad at you? The pastor is the accomplice. The pastor is the one that basically told him to go and kill those children indirectly. It's called auto-suggestion. He suggested wickedness. Yes.
Yeah. Do you understand? On New Year, I wrote on my wall on my Facebook page, I said, today is a payday for pastors, right? You know, it's a payday, they're going to make money. And somebody said, God have mercy on me. Then I said, God have mercy on you, gullible. If you wake up, how would I go there and pack all my money to give to one guy? Because I need to force it to get into 2019 that God has given me for free. I need to force it to get into 2019. But the good thing is that you, Raphael, a lot of other people, the Liberian lady in America, you guys have woken up the people's consciousness. Now, those persons are offended. They are watching all this platform with prosy accounts. Do you understand?
Yes.
You watch all this platform with us. You see them hard.
Yeah.
You know, you guys have really woken people's mind and the culture of this. Now, if you see people are not thinking, we not become a critical and thinker. Do you understand? We critical thinkers before we lack criticism. Do you understand? And my word, do you know what you're doing? God is 100% with you. If God is 100% with you, you would have died long ago. Do you understand me? Because God is with you.
Why would I die for liars? They have been lying all these years. They didn't die. I'm telling you, I know the truth. And I'm going to die. How is that going to work?
That's why their followers, they are so bitter.
But
when you tell them, they are bitter. You see, sorry to say, most Christians who are not Christians, they hate the truth.
Yeah.
Is that because they worship the pastors. They don't worship God. And I swear that if Jesus Christ comes today, Jesus Christ said, let's go left. These guys will put the pastor to right.
Yes, where is my pastor? Where is Pastor Chris going? The most dumb is the biggest there is Pastor Chris.
I used to do this silly thing before. Even before your show came up, I just asked myself one day, the God of Pastor this answer me.
Yeah.
I sit and ask myself, why haven't the God of this pastor is serving?
Why don't you go straight to that God?
Do I even know? I know one day, right? I think I listened to one pastor. Then he said some people are being initiated unknowingly into some occult thing because of this pastor, because of that. The more you say that, you are being yoked inside that trap. You know that. That's why they've been in total. They can't do nothing. They work on your brains. You see, everything they say is about wealth, rich, money. How can somebody tell you your child is a witch? Give them is making you not to be rich. You that can't even do job. You don't have to work. Like what that you three says today, right? It was yesterday. These people have to work, have to make money. Not, oh, you don't have a job, you buy a car. Yeah. What if I'm not working? How do I buy a car in the next week?
Exactly. We don't have money, I'm going to buy the car.
Yeah. I see people buying a car, and you see 100 people will stand up. You understand?
Yeah.
And you see 100 people stand up. So who's the 90 people? There's many 90 people to give them a car. You understand? Is that a chance to wake up? Like what who they said? Yeah?
Yes.
You know, at the end of every financial year, you know, you do analysis about the business. Christians don't do that.
No, they don't.
They analyze everything. They don't.
No.
Do you understand? Yeah. They don't. All they want is just go. Easy. Do you understand? You are sick. Take paracetamol. Go and see a physician and pray to God. You're all right. You know, we don't say that there's no God is not the miracle. He does. But God does not do stupid miracle. You understand me?
Yes.
You can't eat. Like I remember actually by myself that I had a glaucoma. Right? Then I went for an operation. Before I went to question. But remember I told you that the pastor said I should give him the money. And he asked me how much is the operation. I said then it was 250,000 naira. He said I should give the money to someone that I don't have belief in God. God can hear me. Trust me, if I had done that, my young man, I would have been a blind man. I would not be seeing your beautiful face.
Yes.
That wouldn't speak by now.
You know what? Tell us that story again. Tell us that story. Because I really need... I've tried to tell somebody about that story, but I didn't tell it correctly.
Let me tell you.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I came back from Brazil. I went to Nigeria. Then I was still living in Nigeria. And I went to the swimming pool. Immediately I went to the swimming pool, I got up. I realized I was dead for like less than 20 seconds. Do you understand me?
Yeah.
And I went to with my eyes open again. I said, this is not normal. You understand me?
Mm-hmm.
And I went to my, I told my mom. I said, okay, let's go. When I went to, what's it called? The eye doctor.
Yes.
So, yeah. When we got there, they now did run a test on me, in my eyes and everything. They now said, I've got high blood pressure of the eyes. It's called glaucoma.
Mm-hmm.
And they said that sometimes it's erythema, sometimes people with black skin, they almost get it when they are 40 and above. But how come I'm a younger? I think at that time, I was about like 23 or 23, like, I was surprised, you understand me? And nobody in my family had got that trip. So I went to one UBTH hospital, so they said they want to do the operation. And they gave me a book to read and sign. You know what got me scared about that book? There's not even anything happened to my eyes, the 50-50, they can't be all responsible. I said,
Yeah, they
always
say that. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
You understand?
Mm-hmm.
So I was scared about that. Then I said, okay, the only way to, and I was reading about this, to do this operation, to realize it. And I went to the Christ Embassy. My friend was there. I said, let me meet this pastor, because I went to the night of bliss or whatever. So my only intention was, pastor, I'm going to do an operation. Can you assist me in prayer so that it will be successful?
Yeah.
You know what this guy told me? He said, do you have faith? I said, yes. He said, how much is the money for the operation? I said 250,000. He said, I should come and sew it. Then God will heal me, do the operation. Then I told the pastor, it's my mom that want to pay. Let me go and tell my mom. I never go to that church again. And do you know that sometimes I didn't go there again?
Brilliant.
You know that sometime last year, if you watch one of the priest's show, there was one guy who had similar thing. His church, he was believing in God, my church, church, the guy went blind and the church left the guy.
Yeah.
I wrote to the guy on that the priest was, you know what, my brother, I'm sorry you're blind, but he's negligent. You caused it to yourself. But they told him literally to do an operation. He was thinking, you know when they are sick, they say, I'm strong. You are sick, I'm strong. You are poor, I'm rich. You know? Imagine if I had gone with that pastor philosophy, I would have been a blind man.
Yeah.
And you know what? When I came to this country, even the British Citizen, I talked to said, who did the operation since the Nigerian? I said, wow, the person has done a man's job. I did the operation since 2003. Up to date, I don't use medication. It's now I'm fine. Can you imagine?
Brilliant.
If I didn't do that,
yeah,
I would have been in a mess situation by now.
But you know what we're laughing about? This thing that you're just saying, I wanted you to repeat that because I want other people to hear. When you said it the last time, it was when we just started. Do you remember the program?
Yes,
a lot of people need to hear this because people are dying by the day because of these lies and fallacy. A friend of mine too, the same thing. The dad had asthma. Don't waste the money on it. That's what the church told them. Believe in God and keep putting your money and sowing seed. The man died less than 6 months later.
I remember I told you when I sent money to my friend that his brother is sick. The guy that was sick, they said he should be doing fasting, took him from hospital to church to be doing fasting. And the pastor said they should buy 20 bags of meat, they should buy zinc. And the money I sent to them, they're like, oh, what happened? The guy died. And I told my friend, yeah, you killed your brother. The guy died. Somebody that is sick should be doing fasting. Where on earth? And I don't know Bible that much, but I know there's a verse in the Bible, somebody should quote me right, that says, is any of you sick here? These elders are there for you. And go to the elders to pray. He didn't say go to the pastor, the elders.
Yes.
You understand me?
The elders, the professionals. Go to the professionals the and elders. Get treatment, okay? That's what he means in 2019,
all right? Mm-hmm. You understand me? So why would I just go somewhere and the pastor will sit there? The pastor would not tell me that I should discard physician. Right? I know God, I'm not saying God does not work. Nobody should quit me wrong.
No, but God already worked. God already worked by impacting those people that have the knowledge, the medication, to mix it together and be able to give you. What other work do you want God to do? The other thing, I don't understand why they always say if you take medication, you don't believe in God. Of course, who are the people who impacted the knowledge to have the medication in the first place? People were dying in the past because there was no antibiotics. They were using
Maya,
Guinness.
Maya, in your page, right, I met a friend. I've met some few friends. One of the friends I met in your page, she's the daughter of a pastor. She's in America. She said, you're not lying. Everything she says, even the father lied. I come back and said, you're man of God now. She gave me one simple example that when they were traveling, back in the when she was in Nigeria, the dad was bad police. She said, dad, you're not supposed to know. She said, no, that's Nigeria. And you see that kind of guy who pushed sincerity or the people
why
he's bribing behind.
Of course, when he's bribing people.
Yeah, and he will preach sincerity. Can you understand? That's why sometimes when I look at even the pastor's child, she's telling me that what you're doing, she's not agreeing with her dad. That's why. And he even told me, I'm not going to say something that she told me. I'll encourage her to say that said. So I've learned, it's like, she confided on me. I shouldn't say a lot of things on behalf of her. She might even watch it right now.
Yeah, she's free.
Yeah, I don't want to miss her name. She's even on the platform right now. She told me a lot of things. A lot of things that are going behind the scene in the church. Do you understand me? It's like a demonic place. And it's politics. You know, somebody told me that if you're a pastor in Redeem, right? It's like a rebellious person, you're not doing well. So it takes a remote area. Then you may be making something for yourself. You understand? They just say it's a warning. It's a politics thing. Do you understand me?
So we should be wise.
We all should be wise. I thank God for the wisdom He gave to me. Do you understand? And went with what I plan to do. If not, by now, how would I be saying? And imagine I live in Nigeria at that time where you don't even have a social system where the government supports you. And that would be miserable. It's even miserable for a normal guy that has two eyes, you know that, compared to a person with an impaired eye vision.
Yes, exactly.
You know what I'm saying?
They abandon disabled people. They don't even want to. It's like, that's it. God hates them. That's it. They should just go and
Do you know the funny thing when you know that Nigerians don't like disabled people? What the way they view their houses?
Yes, they don't.
They don't consider disabled people at all. They don't consider. I went to Nigeria last year. So there was one shopping mall. They were like, you know this ramp? If you be like, you know the ramp or wheelchair? You know, it was just there. Like, and I asked somebody, why did you think they did this thing? You know, like three of these guys could not tell me the reason why this ramp was. They thought it was just like a slope, a stairway for them to move. The only one guy said to me, for disabled. Do you understand? So because we're not aware about these things. Yeah. You understand?
That's another thing we need to consider for the Nigerian Transformation Project. All those things must change. Anyway, thank you very much. I appreciate your call. Yeah. Thank you. Thank you.
Yeah,
wow. Guys, I'm sorry. I've gone way, way, way over my time. I don't want to do way over my time every time, especially this new year. I want to learn to keep to maximum 1.5 hours. And I've gone over that now. So I do apologize, guys. I will try my best to make sure that we finish this tomorrow. The finale will be tomorrow. Okay? So tomorrow... Oh, there's somebody trying to call. Okay. Let me just answer this one. Hello, caller.
Hello, good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Good morning.
Good morning. Good afternoon.
Yeah, my name is Ife Sinachio Kreke, and I'm calling from the U.S.
Hello, Ife. How are you? Ife Sinach. Hello? I'm fine, thank you. I can't hear you. Hold on. I don't know. The phone has gone off the speaker. Hold on.
Okay,
yeah. Hold on.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you, but not loud enough. So I'm going to put it in the speaker. Okay, go ahead. Go ahead.
Okay, I so much like your program. This is like my third time listening to you.
Thank you.
And can I just have a few minutes to share my own story?
Yes, go ahead.
I live in Maryland, so I have this coworker. Every time he keeps disturbing me, come to my church.
Mm-hmm.
So one day I decided to give in. I went to the church in Maryland, in Bowie. For some people listening, the church is in Bowie. I've forgotten the name of the church.
It's not God Remnants Assembly.
I'm not really sure about the name.
GRA.
Yeah, some have 10 of them within form.
Okay, go on.
So once I got into the parking lot, I was able to identify the pastor car, the wife car, and the deacon car. So the guy asked me, how did you know? I was like, don't worry, I know them a lot. So when I got into the church, they were preaching, and the pastor said, if you know today is the first day and you want to know how to speak in tongues, should come out. So the teaching that the pastor did was, he talked about the speaking of the tongues, and he gave reference about the disciples when they spoke in tongues on the Pentecost day. So then I came out, the guys looked at me to come out, I came out, and everybody else, some other people, they came out too. Everybody fell down except me. The pastor asked me, are you a Christian? I said, yes, I'm a Christian. The pastor said that I need to open up myself so that the Holy Spirit can...
So that you can fall down.
I told the pastor that I understand, but for the Holy Spirit to flow in me, I need to understand what you taught, and I need to believe in what you are teaching. That is the only way the Holy Spirit will flow. The pastor asked me, what do you mean? I told the pastor, if you go back to the Bible,
take him to school.
The people who were listening to the disciples, they were able to understand what the disciples were saying. Some of them were like, wow, we don't know that John the Baptist can speak our language. That means I'm an evil person. I don't know how to speak Yoruba. If I want to teach somebody something who doesn't understand English, That's when the Holy Spirit will come upon me, that I will speak a language that person will understand for me to pass that message. And that was what happened on Pentecost Day. Those people, they were speaking a language which they don't know how to speak before. So, and that was possible at that particular time. So I told the pastor, that's how the Holy Spirit works. That's how speaking in tongues is. I told the pastor, if you show me a place in the Bible, you see all these things you guys are speaking and speaking in tongues. If you show me a place in the Bible that have that kind of thing, that give a reference, say this is speaking in tongues, I will follow you. The pastor told me, as you can see, everybody is under the anointing now.
So what?
You can see everybody is under the anointing. I'll come back to you. I said, okay, at the end of the day, they told us, those people that came here, to stay somewhere.
Mm-hmm.
I stayed somewhere, and the woman asked me what happened there. Did I like the preach? Did I like what I saw there? I told the woman, no. I need to speak to the pastor. They sent for the pastor. The pastor told them to give me a book to read. And the title of the book is Understanding the Holy Spirit.
Mm-hmm.
So she gave me the book, that one is for free. And she told me that there are other ones outside that I have to buy. She took me to the place.
Mm-hmm.
And it was a white lady standing on the one.
Mm-hmm.
The one.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, I told the white lady, I listened to the book. The lady said yes. I told the white lady, this is what happened in the temple when Jesus Christ got to the temple.
Mm-hmm.
And he found out that the people were exchanging. You are doing marketing and he got
over. You are a guest. You're a nightmare guest. Go on.
The woman told me that those people, they were selling cow and all those things. I said, yes, they were selling it because that's what they have.
In this time, they don't have books in those days. Yeah.
That is the same thing. So it's nothing. The woman asked me what church you go to. I told him it's not about the church I go to.
It's about the Christ.
The Bible.
Yes.
You understand it.
Yes.
Stop letting these people fool you.
Yes.
You have take away. Just read your Bible and pray, you can understand it.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm telling my Nigerian people, if they can spend more time,
mm-hmm.
if they can spend more time mm-hmm. doing those things that we ask God to bless them with,
mm-hmm.
when you pray, the mm-hmm. three answers that you get when you pray is either God will do that thing that you pray for at
mm-hmm.
that time,
mm-hmm.
or He will tell you to wait because He knows that you don't need that thing at that particular time,
hmm.
or He will not answer it because He knows that you don't need it.
That's all. Yes.
Bible says before you ask, He already knows what
exactly.
you want to ask.
Exactly.
So some of us pray.
Or He knows that you can get it yourself. You don't need Him. He's already giving you everything that you need. Because it's not always that God don't want to give it to you or you're not ready. Sometimes you're ready, but it's your responsibility to go and get it. Why would you ask me to go and get something that you could get? Even if we're in this world, even in this world as human being, I could be standing next to you and you tell me to go and get something for you. I would still ask you, why don't you go and get it yourself? Won't I? But you want to use prayer to send God on errands. It's not going to do it.
Mm. I'm dating again now. So with this year, we said, okay, we're going to start up a business.
Mm.
I said, okay, then she looked for the shop.
Mm.
I was able to pay for the shop. Then the next thing she said, she's going to talk to her pastor, and pastor will pray for her.
Jeez.
I'm like, why?
Mm-hmm.
She said, so that the pastor will pray, so that the business will grow. Like,
no.
God has already blessed this business. I don't know what you need pastor again for. If God hasn't blessed this business, will you pay $280,000 one time?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
God wouldn't have provided that money.
Mm-hmm.
Even if God provided that money, there would have been something that would make us spend this money.
Mm-hmm. Well done.
It's not only for this stuff. We're still going to have other things to do. And God is already blessing us to bring us this money. So why are you bringing pastor into it again?
Brilliant.
Like, it's taking me time to really take her away from all these pastor.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Nigerians need to wake up.
Wake up, Nigeria. Make up, Nigeria.
For the fact that you wake up every morning, it's already a blessing to you.
Brilliant.
For the fact that you are healthy,
hmm.
you're already blessed.
Yes.
Some of the things that you keep praying every day.
Hmm.
If Nigeria can just stop praying for one day
hmm.
and walk towards those things they have prayed,
hmm.
they will be surprised.
Hmm.
For children, they have already asked.
Brilliant. Thank you, Ife Sinachi. Welcome on board. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Okay.
Keep all the good work.
Thank you.
To change them.
Yes. Thank you. Wow, this caller is on fire. He's got his sound mind screwed on. You know, guys, listen to it again. I'm rushing off because I've done over my time. I do apologize. Tomorrow I really do want to finish Adeboye tomorrow. So tomorrow is Sunday, so that Monday I can start on somebody else. I'm tired of doing all these prophecies and all that in the first place. But I really just want us to get to the bottom of this. I don't like not to do things and finish it properly. So we will end this as well. very soon. Tomorrow I'm going to show scriptures, that's what it says about false prophecies and false prophets. I think it's Sunday, so we can use that as Sunday service. No, I'm only joking. I'm not interested in no Sunday service at all. You know, come as you are. Come and give your contribution and use your sound mind. Unto freedom you're called, everybody. I love you. But Jesus loves you more. God loves you more than anybody can love you. And you cannot be cursed. Nobody can kill you at all. Okay? It's all nonsense. And even if they do kill you, first of all, we're all going to die. Okay? Secondly, if they kill you, it's a win-win. You're going to go to heaven. What's there to be upset about? Why is anybody even upset about death? Okay? You know, what is so great about heaven when you, what is so great about earth when you can go to heaven? Why are you praying to go to heaven? Why are you being nice so that you can go to heaven? So that you can have treasures in heaven, yet you don't want to die and go to that heaven? Please, there is nothing wrong. You will live to fulfill your purpose on earth, and we would all die eventually, okay? I'm looking forward to all of that as well. I'm not going to miss out on anything at all. So I'll do what I need to do on earth, and then I'll go to heaven. You know, me, I'm not afraid to die. I'm not saying I'm not ready to die. I'm not ready to die like that, Dijirin, Adeboye. I'm not ready to die. I'm not ready to die. What you use your advantage here on earth? Please, I beg. Thank you. Thank you very much, everybody. I love you very much. Jesus loves you more. So I'll see you tomorrow. Take care of yourselves. Bye. Bye, guys.